With our level builder, we can draw tiles during runtime. Points, lines and rectangles. But there are a lot of use cases where you want to stack items. Especially having a floor and then something on top of it. This is not working that well at the moment. Okay, it doesn't work at all. But it will, soon. I am going to create a separation of categories for this. But you might use whatever you want and what fits for your needs. Then just do what I do with another variable, if category will have a different use case for you. In simple words, for every category, I will automatically create a tile map, and every item belonging to that category will be drawn onto this tile map. To handle the categories along with their assigned tile maps, I will create a scriptable object for it. This is basically like we did it for the building objects. Also open the building object space. Here we will cut and paste the place type enum to the new file. This is more of a structural decision and will not directly affect the code because the enum is public and therefore available everywhere. Just make sure you don't have two enums with the same name. I add a new entry, none, right at the top. More about this later. Now we want to reform scriptable object and we will also create an entry for the create context menu. This is mainly what we already did before. I add three variables to the scriptable object. The first one is the place type, exactly like in the building object base. The sorting order will be relevant later and decide which tilemap will be above or below. Both values will be set via the Unity UI. The connected tilemap is not a serialized field because we will set it by code. Don't worry, you will understand the fields when we are going to use them. And we also have the getters for those variables. Now go to your building object base and replace the category, which was an enum previously, with the newly created class BuildingCategory. This enum can be removed now. Now all the building objects derive the place type from their assigned building category. This is useful, but maybe some items should have a different one. This is why we added the none value to the place type enum. Every building object itself has a place type value as well. If this is none, then we use the one from the category. Else, we will use the specific one. So let's adjust the place type getter with a ternary operator. If the buildable specific place type variable is none, then return the one from the category, else return the place type variable. So that's it. We can now create the categories. I add a new folder besides the buildables one and can now create the scripted objects. For now, just let the sorting order with its default value of 0 and just assign the correct place types. You also need to update your building objects. Assign our freshly created building categories and also reset the place type of the buildables to none. Or something other if you want to override the place type of the category. So now we have the needed information of how to place the buildables with the categories, but we still need the where. We already created a variable where we can save a tilemap. We just don't have any yet. Since our scripted objects are not inside of a scene, we can't just create tilemaps by hand and assign their values. So let's have some fun by automatically spawning all the tilemaps we need. For this, I'll create a new script called tilemapInitializer. This script will spawn the tilemaps and also assign them to the category they should belong to. Add the tilemaps package and change the code so that this class derives from singleton, because we want to make sure that an object of this class only exists once. This script will be placed inside our scene, so I can create a serialized field for all the building categories I want to initialize. Now, inside the createMaps method, I want to handle the tilemap creation for every category inside this list. Before continuing, make sure to call this method inside the start method of the class. When manually creating a tilemap, you basically just create an empty object and add two components. The tilemap itself and the tilemap renderer. And this is also how to do it via script. We're going to create an object, then create and assign the specific features for a tilemap. To make sure it will be placed inside the grid, we also need to assign a parent. When creating a new game object, the name is the first parameter inside the brackets. Now this is just the file name of the category, but you could also prefix tilemap, for example. With the addComponent method of the object, we can create and assign the components, and also save them inside a variable, because we will need them later. For assigning the parent, we need a variable as reference. Parents are always assigned as transform, so use this as type. Then just assign it like this. Now it's time for settings you may want to apply. In our case, there also is one. The sorting order. This comes from the tilemap renderer, so we use the variable for this, and just set the value from the one we added to the category. Great! Now, theoretically, we created a bunch of tilemaps. We just need to assign them to the category. Add the according setter to your building category script for the tilemap. This will simply replace the value of the private tilemap variable with the given one. Now we can do this with this line. Note that we use the tilemap component of the object, not the object itself. Let's see if this works. Back in Unity, assign the initializer script to your manager object. Assign the grid of the tilemaps as parent, and inside the list, add the categories you want to create a tilemap for. I'll just use two to show you that it works. When you now start the game, two new tilemaps get added, and they are named to our schema. Now, to see if the drawing process will also work, we need to adjust the building creator script a little bit. Let's create a getter where we can dynamically retrieve the tilemap. If there is an object selected, and the object's assigned category has a tilemap, we will return it. Else, we will use the default map. In our case, the items category does not have a tilemap, and therefore should be drawn to the default map. Since we used the default map until now, I can just search for the code parts I used this variable, and replace it with our new tilemap variable. Well, it should work now. I switch to play mode. When I now draw a floor, and then hide the floor tilemap, it disappears. So we know it was drawn onto the correct map. But all maps have currently the same order and layer value of 0. We can stack items, but they are not in the right order. Good thing we already prepared everything for this. Just go back to where you defined your building categories and change the number. The floor should always be on the bottom, so I give it a negative value. This value then gets assigned to the tilemap renderer here in this code part. When drawing, I can now draw on top. So currently, the wall tilemap is above the default one, which leads to this behavior. The door gets not drawn on top, but it still gets drawn. In this case, we can just remove the creation of a separate wall map from the list, and then both would get drawn onto the default map. But this is not always practical. Well, an option to check if we can draw with this object at this position is not that easy. You might draw a door on top of a floor, but not on top of a wall. So I hope you see what I mean, because we won't discuss this topic in this video, and also focus on basic features for the next episodes. So stay tuned for an upcoming solution to this problem. Thank you for watching, and also thank you to everyone supporting me and the channel. Special thanks to my supporters on Patreon, Patrick and NaxWomo. Thank you all. And as usual, if you enjoyed the content, consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you next time.